What's up guys, it's dingersdaily. Today we're going to be looking at the interesting career of Detroit Pistons forward Josh Jackson. How on earth Josh Jackson went from a bust with a bunch of scandals to now a player who's averaging 17 points per game. We'll see all of that here with more in-depth analysis and how he's changed his career, turned it all around, and what's ahead for Josh Jackson as a Detroit Piston. Before we continue more about Josh Jackson and how he came back, let's talk about today's sponsor, Simbull. Now, Simbull is a sports company that has created kind of like a stock market for sports that allows you to buy and sell shares of football and basketball teams in the NBA or NFL. It's kind of like the stock market for sports teams. Every time you own a team and they win a game, you receive a weekly win payout. It's kind of like a dividend in the stock market from a company. The best part is, if the team you own loses, you don't lose anything since your investment holds value. Simbull has blended the stock market and gambling to create this new form of investing that allows users to profit off their sports knowledge without the high gambling fees. You can now own shares of your favorite NFL and NBA teams with the chance to earn weekly payouts while also having an investment that appreciates in value. And the best part is, you don't lose money. Visit simbull.app/dingersdaily to learn more or click the link in the description. As you know, today we're going to be talking about the interesting case of Detroit Pistons forward Josh Jackson. Now, I like to think of Josh Jackson's situation kind of like one of former Washington football team quarterback Dwayne Haskins. Haskins got released last week and he was a very high pick, projected to be really good, had some scandals and issues off the court. And if you actually look at it, Josh Jackson had a very similar first stint of his NBA career. The difference between Dwayne Haskins and Josh Jackson was that Josh Jackson got that second chance and he balled out in his second chance. Dwayne Haskins, we still don't know if he's going to get that second chance. But this is just a little comparison I like to make. Jackson had two underperforming seasons, you could say, in Phoenix, his rookie season and sophomore season. Then he went to Memphis last year, where he spent about half the year with their G League team. And I think that helped him like regain his confidence. And then this year in free agency, the Pistons signed him, and with Blake Griffin with some injuries, he was put into a starter role, and he's doing really good, career high in points, rebounds, and blocks. And he's just more efficient than he ever was, and we're starting to see, you know, maybe a glimpse of what the Suns hope. And they took him with the fourth pick in the 2017 draft. Jackson's first two seasons in Phoenix, he was averaging 12.3 points, 4.5 rebounds, 2 assists, 1 steal, half a block. Now, if you look at his averages through 6 games in Detroit, or 5 games in Detroit, he's averaging around 16 to 17 points with 2 assists, 1 steal, and 4.5 rebounds. If you just look at these raw stats, you may think he's the same guy, he's only got better in maybe by like 3-4 points, and assists, rebounds, everything is the same. Now, the main aspect of the game where he's changed is field goal percentage. Back when he's with Phoenix, his 2-point percentage was 47%. Now in Detroit, his 2-point percentage is 61%. And it's also his regular field goal was 42%, which is not good. It's below average. Here in Detroit, it's at 49%, which is really good. He's playing around the exact same minutes, a bit less, but I think Josh Jackson's improved a lot in efficiency, so we don't see him as such a bad player. Because back when he was with Phoenix, he was shooting a lot of shots, well, as many shots as he is in Detroit. He just wasn't making any. So if you just looked at the raw stats and said he averages 12 points and 5 rebounds, someone would think he's a good role player. But now when we think Josh Jackson averages 16 points and 5 rebounds with way better efficiency, now you can say he's an actual decent NBA player, and he's turned his career around like crazy. He went from a bust to almost like 15 to 20 points, he's scoring 15, 20 points with crazy efficiency. So I think great things are ahead for Josh Jackson. I'm happy he turned his career around, and especially got out of all that scandal stuff. And I don't think Phoenix was a great environment for him. He's played well in Detroit, and I think he can learn from Jeremy Grant. He can learn from Blake Griffin, and with Blake Griffin most likely out of Detroit soon, it seems like Josh Jackson might be approaching a starter role, and he'll thrive. I think he'll thrive in that starter role. He'll turn his career fully around. The last stat we're going to be talking about is win shares per 48. When he was in Phoenix for both the years, in his rookie season, his win shares per 48 was negative 0.018, and his second year was negative 0.040. Now, those are terrible. League average is 0.1. In Memphis, it's 0.069, which is below average. This year in Detroit, he's not above average, but he's slightly below average. And since we're only like 5 to 6 games in the season, he has a 0.83 win shares for 48, which over the season, I think it will get better. He'll actually become an average NBA player. Before, when he was in Phoenix, all the numbers are in the negatives, which is just terrible. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit that like button, and comment down below whether you agree or disagree about the whole Josh Jackson story. Again, thanks to Simbull for sponsoring this video. Use simbull.app/dingersdaily or click the link in the description to find out more. Thank you guys, it's been dingersdaily. Have a great rest of your day. Stay safe, happy holidays, and bye.